Hi, I'm Lee from Educative. You're watching a segment from a special series of Educative Sessions with Fahim ul-Haq, the co-founder of Educative. In this episode, Fahim speaks candidly about his experiences in university and his thoughts on the relevance of mathematics in becoming a successful programmer. Enjoy the session. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Educative Sessions, a podcast with people within the developer world about their coding experiences. This is powered by Educative, which makes it easy for authors to provide interactive and adaptive courses for software developers. My name is Lee Ngo. Today, we have, of course, a special guest in Fahim ul-Haq, who is the co-founder of Educative and also the CEO. And we're going to take a little bit of a different format than our usual Educative Sessions and really, really open it up to a lot of questions that Fahim may have never been actually asked before. And while he's pre-approved a lot of our questions, it's still, we still might go in a lot of different directions and we'll just see how it goes, right? So Fahim, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me. And now I'm more scared than ever.
Yeah, that's the point, right? I want to see how you do under pressure. And really relish this moment because I don't think I'm going to have any more like this. So, you know, a lot of different directions. And honestly, I don't want to start by setting up the usual pretense questions. Like, of course, you are the co-founder of our company and it's been quite a journey so far. But I'm much more interested in the person before that. Let's start back in your days of being in higher education, being that this is an educational initiative. And I think those are some of the most formative times for you, right? When it comes to the work you're doing now. So what was being at university like for you? Let's just start there.
So I went to the university in Pakistan. I did my undergrad from Pakistan in Punjab University of Information Technology, or as we call it, PUCIT. And it was an amazing experience. We were the second batch, and the computer science program was a new program that the university had started. Even though the university itself is more than 100 years old, and I don't recall the date when it was founded, but it was like somewhere in 1800s. Mm-hmm. But the computer science program for them was pretty new. And so in a lot of ways, we were, you know, the first people who were going through the program. The tweaks were, all of the tweaks that they had to make in the program were pretty much on the fly. Mm-hmm. But overall, it ended up being a great program. I still am connected with a lot of teachers with whom I spent a great lot of time. I learned a lot from them. And I still, cherish those moments.
That's great. And, you know, so you were, you know, in Pakistan at the time, and then of course came over to America. You didn't go to any formal schooling in America, right? I think you came over to professionally work.
Yes, I came here to work for Microsoft. Mm-hmm. And while working for Microsoft, I did enroll in the evening UDEM master's program for computer science.
Oh, okay.
So I did sort of did my graduate from UDEM, but it was an evening program.
So. I see. How would you compare the programs?
Very different. Yeah. First of all, it was graduate studies versus undergraduate studies. And mm-hmm. undergraduate studies has to be more structured anywhere in the world. And being in Pakistan, it was slightly more structured than it would have been here. But overall, you have a lot of flexibility during your graduate studies. And you can choose, pick and choose the subjects. And I did it over a longer period of time where I would just skip the whole quarter if there was no course that I really liked or I was really busy in the job. Versus when you're in a university program, when you're in an undergraduate program, you want to finish it in 4 years. And sometimes the subjects that you're taking up are the subjects that you really like. Sometimes you have to take some of the subjects that you don't like. And it was true for me as well. Some of the subjects that I took, I was not really passionate about them. Some of them were mandatory.
Right.
But in the graduate program, I didn't take even one single subject or one single class in which I was not interested.
Got it. So it sounds, how would you compare it, at least from a geographical sense? Like, was there a very specific philosophy or goal in the Pakistani learning system versus the American learning system?
So the Pakistani learning system, from the very beginning, from even the schools, it's more structured, and the lanes are narrow and mm-hmm. the guardrails are up. So mm-hmm. so everybody goes through a very similar program. You learn pretty much with everyone else in your semester, in your batch. And there is less choice, which also means that being in Pakistan, you have, the number of teachers that you have is also puts a big constraint on what topics can you teach, can you mm-hmm. offer. Mm-hmm. And in universities like Stanford or UW or University of Washington, you have more choices because you have people who have researched in diverse subjects, and a lot of people come, very smart people are teaching here. So there was some differences, but what I would say is that I have no complaints about my undergraduate study. It was executed better than most universities in the world. And that would include the top 10 universities. We had great teachers, we had great mentors. If I look back, and even today when I'm solving a programming question or I'm struggling with a problem, I still go back to those days. I still I still remember some of the classes and still go back to the first principles that I learned back then and use them to solve a problem. So yeah, love the experience.
Got it. So, from a much more structured experience than, say, in the United States that you had when you were in Pakistan, to your graduate studies, to, the work that you're doing now, these are all quite, thorough experiences in higher education. But where do you see programs like four-year programs and other kinds of programs that train people in computer science going, right? It sounds like it took 4 or 5 years. Is that correct? Another year?
Four years. Yeah.
So, do you think that remains the pattern or the system for a lot of people to get into computer science? Do you see something changing in, in the ecosystem, especially when it comes to things that are online? And it doesn't have to specifically do with Educative, but I'm very interested in where you see right now. If you had the opportunity right now, what would you be doing?
I think there is a much larger debate happening around us around whether four-year programs are necessary to do some of the jobs or not. And a big debate that you see is that, if you want to become a software developer, do you really need to go through a four-year computer science program? And there is a slight difference between a software developer and a computer scientist. So my opinion is that if your only aim is to become a software developer, probably 4 years is an overkill. But the current computer science programs are designed to create computer scientists. Many of them actually go on to do their graduation in the same subject, and some of them actually go and do their PhD in the same subject. So the program in itself is designed to cover a lot of different subjects so that people can become software developers, people can become computer scientists, they can go and do higher studies in computer science. Everybody knows that there's a lack of developers in the world, and Educative to a certain degree helps with creating more developers in the world as well. So we are very aware of the problem. So I think that there is definitely an opportunity to create a program for software engineers, which is of, I would say, 18 to 24 months. It would have a lot of the same subjects that you would study during a computer science four-year program, but then there will be a lot of subjects that you won't study, and you won't typically find a need for those topics in your typical day-to-day software engineering.
Got it. So I think what you did was very critical in making the distinction between computer science versus software development. Would that also include a distinction from software engineering? Because I think a lot of these terms get conflated when people describe, like, or even just being a coder, or, you know, there's a lot of floating terms all around. But could you clarify, at least just briefly before we move on, the distinction between those categories?
I think that one is a computer scientist, and then I would use all of the other terms interchangeably for software engineers. For example, software engineer, software developer, coder, programmer, all of those terms in my mind refers to the same thing, that you're working on a computer, writing a code to build software.
Got it. That's crazy helpful. So, you know, and perhaps we should have started with this question beforehand. You also wanted to talk a lot more about your experiences prior to higher education, specifically in mathematics, right? And I'm going to say the term math because I grew up in America. You're probably going to say the term maths because you grew up in Pakistan. So, but we're going to be respectful and interchange them, and maybe use them just so that people get confused. If they get confused, then we can clarify that, right? But you know, I have my own thoughts on this, but I wanted to hear more about your thoughts on, you know, what was your own early experience in mathematics? Because just to remind everybody, you are now a co-founder and CEO of a technological, you know, company. But math, however, while, you know, perhaps fundamental, this might have been different for you. So we'll start there.
Okay, so I know where this is going. So I would be very upfront about it that I don't think that I'm good at math. And contrary to the popular belief that programmers have to be good at math, I think that's not true, or that's not entirely true at all. Because math entails a lot of subjects like calculus and linear algebra and differential equations, where you would get some like good ideas in programming or writing, or while you're writing software, but a lot of times those skills are not needed. But actually, I would say most of the times, those skills are not needed. And I am a living example of that. I'm not good at calculus or linear algebra or differential equations. I would say for a programmer, the most important thing that you need to like know is logic. If you can logically think about a problem, you could like think about the solutions, and you can say, well, if this happens, then I will do that. Or if that happens, then like there's another set of instructions that this program needs to execute. If you can think of, if you can break up the problems into logical pieces and connect the dots between those logical pieces, that's the extent of math or logic that you would need to write a typical software. Learning a little bit of algebra helps sometimes. And beyond that, I think that there are diminishing returns.
Hi there. Hope you enjoyed this episode with Fahim. If you'd like to watch more episodes, we've added them here. Be sure to like this episode and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Happy learning.